I'm going to England.
I'll do what I've always wanted to do. See England.
I'm going to do my OE.
If that's all they're thinking of me, to hell with them.
I'm going to write a novel. Travel. And then write a novel about it.
At last, Ness, some balls that have given me pleasure. No, I've won lotto. Second division, 8,000. So I'm leaving line. A woman can only take so much. No, he doesn't know. I mean, he'll know I'm leaving when the time comes. I just won't tell him I'm not coming back. Yeah, so with the 8 grand, plus what I've already put by, I'm going to England. My fantasy is just that one step closer. You know. Give Lionel the choice between seeing the Grand Canal in Venice and putting in pink bats. He will choose pink bats every time. Oh, except, of course, he put them in ages ago. They were my 15th wedding anniversary present.
Dear loved ones, well, Alan's gone. As decent as a man as any of us would wish to meet. And he was a long time going. Thank you, everyone, for your letters of sympathy. Apologies, Connor, and to most of which I am asked personally. Some news. I'm going to do what we always said we would do. See. I'm really sorry.
Wednesday. Once when I was quite small, friends were called in unexpectedly. Disaster. The tins were empty. My mother went to the kitchen, and for the only time in my life, I heard her say, "Bugger it." This morning, the woman in HR called and wanted to see me. She said, "I'm sorry, Jean, but we're letting you go." I said, "I wasn't aware I'd been straining at the leash." 30 years at Denison Hedger Construction. Surely loyalty means something. Evidently not. 6 months' pay plus sick leave owing to me. No prospects. A woman in her late 50s isn't going to get another job. I came home and howled. I felt frightened. Tonight, I remembered my mother's biscuit tin and her words came back to me. Bugger it. I'll go overseas.
It's easiest in writing your first novel to write about people and places that are familiar to you. When writing a novel, try and grab your reader by the throat from the very first sentence.
Ruth should have said something was wrong when Neil arrived from Collingwood one day from milking the cows. He poured himself a large glass of whiskey and said, "I phoned 400 tits a day and never get a single smile." A week later, he came home with streaks in his hair. There had to be another woman. Sure enough, there was. Brett Davis's Shannon's wife down the road. Not surprising, really. Shannon had led so many husbands astray. But she was known throughout the industry as the superator. Ruth and Neil had been on farm for too long. They'd brought up 3 daughters and a son. All had gone now. It was time for a change. Was this what had led her into signing up for a how to write a novel course? Neil, as it seemed, had found a different hobby. Ruth had suggested to Neil that to sort things out, maybe it was time to travel, especially now that his son Ruth was living in London. Neil had said yes, he was planning to travel. Bali with Sharon. Ruth had told Neil that if he was going to go to Bali, he might as well go now. Go from the house. The next day, Sharon moved into her husband's friend in the bar in New Plymouth. Neil was left milking Brett Davis's herd, but for a fraction of the income. Ruth hadn't quite seen the point.
Thursday. Bad day. Winnie. Felt remorse. Brought him some gourmet fish risotto to make amends. Saturday. Big decision. We'll use some of my savings. Shirley died at my age, so who knows what's around the corner. She would have come like a shot. My mother's father came from England. Bert Hawkswood. Uncommon surname, so might not be too hard to trace. Sunday. Decided on another project. To see as many of the cathedral towns of England as I can. I've always wanted to see the mousetrap. Went to travel agent and booked tickets before I got frightened and changed my mind. Got home and was frightened. My last day teaching Denise. Farewell, yes sis, I'm free. I know now how Mandela felt getting off Robben Island. I booked a ticket. Told Lionel making a little trip. Over to be in England now that April. He took it quite calmly. I did sort of say, did he want to come? I don't know what I'd done if he'd said yes. But I knew he wouldn't want to spend the money. I'll stay with Shelley. She said I could doss down fast if I got over there. Bayswater somewhere. Just until I find a place of my own. Oh, Lionel will be fine. Stacy, our cleaner, assured me she'd keep an eye on him. I think Lionel's looking forward to having the house to himself.
After a few days, desolation turned to anger. She now felt nothing but contempt for him. She would do two things she had always wanted to do. She would travel, and she would write a novel, and she would call the novel Spitting Distance. Dear Bond Street Nursing Agency, Noel Julia McLennan, age 55, 50, nursing experience and other CV details on attached file, last job palliative care unit, Middlemore Hospital, health, good, driving license, and looking for a living situation preferably in central London.
A lot achieved in a week, made a list of lists, including a list of what lists to make. Clothes, cotton bra for easy washing, good skirt, travel book said sarong, doubles as towel, tablecloth and dressing gown. A sarong, well, why not? Brought a pair of cuffs. Torch, adapter plug, knife, spoon and fork set, device for boiling water in a cup, traveller's clothesline, no pegs required, joined New Zealand Historic Places Trust. Reciprocal arrangement means free admission to trust properties. Tried on tight stockings, supposed to prevent deep vein thrombosis. Hard to put on, harder to get off. Might risk DVT. Booked room in B&B near Victoria for 3 nights. Have to pay in advance. £60 a night. Shirley's daughter Georgie has just returned from overseas and will house it. Not clear to me why she can't pay rent. Be disappointing. have to be even thriftier on travels.
Roof left the farm without a backwards glance. Taxi here for the airport. Here already. Wish me luck. Lot no one.
At the airport, checked over travellers' aid stuff to see if I'd forgotten anything. Hadn't.
Denise, at the airport, alarm will drop me off but wouldn't stay. Didn't want to pay for parking. Oh, I got my duty free vodka and ciggies. I really should give up. Oh, and some Elu. I'm putting some on now. Just in case the man beside me has a chauffeur driven car at Heathrow and offers me a ride into town, and then invites me to share his room at the Savoy, a room overlooking the Thames.
Somewhere over the Pacific.
You can see churches, fields, villages.
Drinking lots of water, taking no jet lag. Had a meal, chicken pilaf. Wrong choice. Couldn't hear the film properly. Legs swollen despite doing the exercises. I was the only one rolling my head around doing buttock clenching exercises. Woman beside me is off to London to see her son. She'd had two whiskies and then talked to me about her broken marriage. Fathers. She referred to some bitch in heat down the road. Details I didn't want to know. Wish I hadn't come.
Over England, the Thames.
Motorways, everything very green, like opening shots of Vicar of Dibley.
Ruth was excited, but tearful.
Tower of London, Houses of Parliament, the Thames.
It's swollen, can't get my cups back on.
Place your main character in some predicament which he or she has to resolve.
He wasn't at the airport. Her son, who promised he'd be there. So, a crash course and learning how to use the underground. Number 77, a sleepy black man answered and beckoned her into the hallway. He shouted, "Hey, Griff, visitor for you." Movement inside the room, and then her son opened the door. "Shit, Mum! I thought it was tomorrow," and then sniffed. This wasn't the welcome Ruth had imagined.
This B&B is appalling. Dark, cold, and dirty. The wardrobe is crammed in the corner, only has one door and one coat hanger. The ensuite, shower, toilet, jammed in the corner of the room. They switch off the hot water at 9 a.m. Breakfast is unspeakable. £60 a night. If I hadn't prepaid, I could have left.
shit legs, so walking around during the day like a zombie. St. Paul's was magnificent, but I was too tired to appreciate it. Forgot to buy my tea towel. Came back to my wretched room and howled, wish I hadn't come. Lionel, just to let you know I'm here, in London. I'm safe. The flights are on time. I'll let you know as soon as I have somewhere permanent. Well, that's all really. Bye, dear. Denise, I can't believe I'm actually here, in London. To be honest, Shelley was a bit surprised to see me, as if she thought I'd never actually take her up on her offer. I'm so excited. Oh, I'm sleeping on Shelley's floor. I assured her it's only for a few days and then I'd pay my way and all that. Now I'm going to hit the town. Oh, I don't know. Pub? Club? Anything. I can't not go out. Not my first night in London. Look out, London. Here I come.
Griffin agreed to let her sleep in his bed until she got established and he would sleep on the floor. She told him the news about Shannon and Neil. He seemed to take the news surprisingly calm and seemed to dismiss it with a sniff. So the next morning, she had to pick her way onto her son's body in his sleeping bag, down through the halls into the communal little shower. The floor was always wet. That first morning, about to go to the shops, she'd put on her bum bag, and Griffith said, why don't you put an arrow on your shirt with a sign saying, all valuables here? Then added, besides, it makes you look like a tourist anyway, and laughed.
Monday. Have to find somewhere else to stay from tomorrow. Tried some hotels, but very expensive. Then, I saw in the shop window an advertisement. Accommodation and breakfast. With a coach tour. All for £299. That's almost what I'm paying without meals. I almost didn't care where the buses were going. Oxford, Cotswolds, and West Country. It leaves tomorrow morning at 7. Went to see the mousetrap. I fell asleep in the second half, so I still don't know who did it. I didn't like to ask.
Hello, loved ones. Forgive the joint layer, but impossible to do it individually. First day in London. Went to the agency. Posh address, scummy office, up three flights of stairs, and Mrs. Gunther, dressed in a nurse's uniform, what a hoot, interviewed me. She glanced at my references and then picked a name from a set of cards. Mrs. Harriet Delisle Courtenay, fixed fused, rather deaf. Wants living carrier, St. John's Wood. So I get my accommodation and nearly £400, one day off per week. Mrs. Harriet Delisle Courtenay, DC from now on, is tiny, so fragile. She cannot cope with my name. There is no such name as Nolene, she says. Windowline, yes, but not Nolene. Must go. Madame is bleating for attention. Love,